to the voice from heaven. Listen to the voice of heaven. Can you hear it? Listen, listen, listen the voice of God. There is a man shouting in the desert, saying, prepare the way of the Lord. Make his path straight. Change your life, then your sin can be forgiven. The Lord of the glory was in heaven. He came on the earth. He died on the cross. He raised from the dead. Before he could ascend in heaven, he opened eyes and understanding of his disciples so they could understand the scriptures. I mean, he opened eyes and understanding so they could understand the scriptures. I mean, he opened eyes and understanding so they could understand the scriptures written about him from Genesis to Malachi. He told his apostles to preach about repentance and the remission of the sins in his name, starting at Jerusalem. Most of the people claim that apostles, pastors, evangelists, teachers, and prophets judge them in preaching the true gospel. They always ask, do these people holy? Do apostles, pastors, evangelists, teachers holy? Let's read in the book of 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 17 to 19. We will hear.
Men of God, sorry to interrupt you. Here is a question. Did Jesus Christ sin? Was him a criminal?
Thanks for your question, Mr. Jax. Jesus Christ didn't sin. Men used force. They took him. They didn't judge him fairly. He died and he was buried with the rich people and the evil people. He never do anything wrong. He didn't speak lies, but all the other things happened on him. People called him as he was a criminal. But the truth is, he carried the sins of many people. Him was not a criminal, but because of our sins. Some others, they took him as a criminal, but he was the one to save us. He saved us by dying on the cross. That is true, my friends. I'm not sure if you are happy for this answer.
A reading in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 17 to 19 says, for the time has come for judgment to begin at the house of God.
And if it begins with us first, that will be the end of those who do not obey the gospel of God. Oh, if the righteous one is scarcely saved, where will the ungodly and the sinner appear? Therefore, let those who suffer according to the will of God commit their soul to him in doing good, as to the faithful creature.
Ngitshele mfundisi, abapostoli baka Jesu Christ bebevaleke amehlo noma izindlebe na? Uma uthi cha mfundisi, ngitshele kungani uJesu abavule amehlo nemiqondo?
Remember I told you that Jesus Christ opened eyes and understandings of his apostle. I mean this. The scriptures was written about him from Genesis to Malachi. But apostle didn't know about. Moses wrote, Jeremiah wrote, Joshua wrote, Isaiah wrote, and as a prophet, both of them were to prepare the way of the Lord. Remember when Isaiah say, there will be a man shouting in a desert, prepare the way of the Lord. And the man came, the man was John baptized. The man came and they said same thing, prepare the way of the Lord. Repent your sins to be baptized. That was the preparation of the way of the Lord. Remember again, Jesus Christ said, you are focusing in reading the scriptures, but the scriptures cannot give life, but himself was the one to give that life forever. He means to follow him than following the scriptures. Amen.
Isaiah 35 verse 8 to 9 says, at that time there will be a road there. This highway will be called the Holy Road. Evil people will not be allowed to walk on that road. No fool will go to that road. Only good people will walk on that road. There will be no danger on that road. There will be no lions on that road to hurt people. There will be no dangerous animal on that road. That road will be for the people God saves.
Amen.
My pastor, why prostitutes, robbers, witches, drunkards, liars, idolates, won't walk in the way of holiness?
A person must be truly happy if he doesn't follow the advice of bad people and he doesn't live like a sinner. A good people think about the teaching of God day and night. He is like a tree planted on the stream of water. He is like leaves which not die. Everything he does, he is successful. Bad people are not like that. Raise, you are sleeping in the darkness. God need you. Jesus Christ wants you, him, the King of salvation. The Bible says the time of judgment is coming, and that time will start with us first, will start with us in the house of the Lord. Worry about a prostitute, idolates, killers, robbers, liars, witches. Worry about them. Where are they going to be at the last time? The book of Isaiah 35 verse 8 to 9 says, there will be a highway and a way, the way of holiness. Fools, unholy people, ravenous animals, witches, liars will not walk over it. It will be the way of the saved people, the way of the redeemed. That's why I say this kind of the people won't be in that way. The way is holy. How can unholy walk in the way of the holiness? They must first come to Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ purify
after be purifying, then they want to walk in the way. Simple. Are you happy with my explanation? You happy? Thank you very much if you understand me. Hebrews chapter 9, verse 26 to 28 says, he then who have had to suffer often since the foundation of the world, but now, once at the end of the age, he has appeared to put away his sins by the sacrifice of himself. And as it is appointed for men to die once, but after this, the judgment. So Christ was offered once to bear the sins of many. To those who eagerly wait for him, he will appear a second time apart from sin for salvation. Brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers, friends, you heard what the Bible says. Jesus Christ is coming to collect those waiting for him. Who are waiting for him? The Bible said the righteous are saved hardly. Where will be those who do not obey the gospel of God? Where will be the prostitutes, the killers, the idolaters? Are them going to walk in the way of holiness? Are they going to hug Jesus Christ? I think no. Because the way has a rule, you cannot walk in that way if you don't complete the rule, if you don't follow the command and the rules of that way. Then we call you to come to Jesus Christ. We call you to come and learn the true teachings, the holy teaching from Jesus Christ, then you will know how to walk in the way. You will know how to wait for Jesus. We invite you, fathers, we invite you, mothers, we invite you, friends, come to Jesus Christ when it's still early. Don't wait the last day. The Bible tells us that the judgment is coming. The time of judgment is now coming. Then come to him, still time, still early. I will be happy to see you coming, to see you coming to the Lord of the glory. Thanks very much for all of you who are hearing me. Thanks very much to all of you who will take this message serious. I will praise God when you will know this truth, and this truth will set you free, and this truth will open your way to Jehovah God. This truth will open your way to heaven. In the name of the multi-power Jesus Christ, we say amen.
Se siphumeka kolo ngendaba yeBhayibhele, as iBhayibhele ithi kuhle okuhlupheka nkosini, sithi ukuhle kulabo bayahlupheka kwentando kaNkulunkulu. Manje ke sifuna ukumuzwa uMamthumba omasibiya azatinigiti, because again wahlupheka kakhulu, wabuya la eshowe, wabula itafula, leli tafula leliya liyamsiza kakhulu. Then again sifuna ukumuzwa, simuzwe asitshele kabanzi about itafula lakhe limpilisa kanjani inkosini. Mamchumba, we tafula la vele, ili apuluisa kanya, na wazi kuschela, kuschela shukuru. Iti mitola. That's true. We are happy to hear you. As you tell us about this small business, we are very happy. Then we still advise you to always tell other people how they can manage to open their small business instead of going stealing, of going selling their bodies, of going drinking, and of going doing so many wrong things around these places. They will cope to you and they will do the right, and they will be also in the true and the right way. We are so happy to hear that, sister. Thank you very much. May God bless you deep and deeper. In the name of Jesus Christ, we praise him forever and ever. Amen. As the ministers of Jesus Christ, visiting house to house and place to places, here we are in the front of our old man, a lovely friend, Gavenda. We want to hear what he will advise the gentle people, the new generation. Papa Gavenda, want to hear you. We heard that here around Ishawe, there are people selling drugs, there are also ladies that are selling themselves, and this, according to our Lord Jesus Christ, is not totally good. What do you advise about those people?
I met my brother, Pastor Chris, a few years ago, and I was delighted to know that he was a Christian. And I found that he was a very faithful Christian. And
Thank you very much, Papa Gavenda. Your message was fantastic. And I'm very sure all the people that will hear you, all the people that will get this message, they will have salvation at the end of hearing your voice. Thank you very much. You're most welcome. Welcome again to our Jesus Christ ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor.
I'm not going to talk about this. I'm not going to talk about
this. I'm not going to talk about this. I'm not going to talk about this. I'm not
going to talk about this. I'm not going to talk about this.
I was just like, I'm not going to be able to do it. Angizukuhlala nawe, angizube ngingakwazi ukuthi wenzani lapho khona. Okwami ukuthi kufanele ngikuthembe njengomuntu engithandana naye. ngazi mina ukuthi lapho khona uthembakela ukuthi wena wenzani ngale mina ngizobe ngingabonzi ngazi nawe kuzobe kuyinto efanayo njengoba nawe usenza ukungathembeki nje kunomuntu othandana naye usufika la usuyayibika kumina
hayi mina ukhona kodwa akusekho
akusekho awutsheli ngani pho I was going to go to the house.
I guess Timber, I don't want my hobbins. Look, I go so bad. But I have something in me now. So, Tabe, I hate it. It was a looking summer. Will Tabe to the Lily Lam?
And
then, so I'm going to go to the house.
Some small guys, gentlemen around here in Shawe, those need to give themselves to Jehovah Lord. Here we have one of our brothers, as he claimed himself to be a drug dealer. He claimed himself to smoke and to drink beers time and time, but he wants God to help him in order to leave those wrong ways to come to salvation. Let you hear him, what he will express by his own mouth. Brother, you have what to talk about, what the ministers around this place, so they can come and assist you and help you. What do you tell them about?
What I can say is, I would like to stop smoking. I would like God to help me to succeed in my future. I also want God to help me stop smoking, drinking, drugs, things. I want to go to the army, I want to go to the army. Yeah, now I want to go to the army. I want to see you in the army. I want to go to 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 the army. So it's not time to see them now. But I've called you. I've also watched what's Thursday and the word of gospel. No man can do bands in my if you once hooked up with drugs and everything. You can't do bands in who would see a poop. So yesterday, I saw the chemist to look at the moon to look at the water. Okay, I get a reason for this, like using drugs. They say, sing the mania maruza, my shooty, Oma was a fool at the moon to learn. Never accepting an alum's idea. So, ngagcina futhi nanamhlanje ngigcina futhi ngigcina futhi ngibhemona futhi amagilazi. At home bayazama ukuthi bangisupporte and everything. Kodwa nami ngiphinde ngiphambuke nami ngendlela engingayiqondi kahle. Tuthi ngigcine sengibuyela kuwona futhi amagilazi.
Yeah, we're thankful to hear what you... Brother, so happy to hear what you said. Don't worry, Jesus Christ is the solution. When you say by yourself, you claim, I want to live this thing, God will help you. God will assist you. And this is as a shout to the ministers around these places. Both will hear, they will come to you. They will correct you, they will advise you, they will show you the true way. And your future life will be very correct. And we will be happy to see you change and to be in a normal way of living. Thanks for your time. May our God change your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, we appreciate that. Amen. I'm Pastor Alfonso Warally Chris. Here in front of one brother needs salvation. He's smoking, drinking, 24 hours at a minute. Then he cries to people in order to help him. Let's hear what himself is gonna say through his man, brother.
So I thank God for this opportunity. Yeah, I'm an addict with ganja, alcohol too much. But I want to leave all those things. I want God to help me to leave those things. Because my life is not the same like before. God let me. I'm a change. I need a change. Thank God.
Friends, brothers, I am Pastor Alfonso Warally Chris. So happy for your time. I met you for the first time. Now today is the second time. I'm coming to see if you start to change. You claim, you declare yourself that you want God to change your life. And as I know, the changement of someone who's using drugs and beers and deep alcohol, it's not easy. But when you give yourself to God, and when we always come to visit you, to counseling you, psychologically, spiritually, we are sure that you will change. We always need you sometimes to approach pastors, sometimes to go to the churches. There, you will find also deep advice and the consolation. In sitting here, you will never change. Because the Bible says, in Jesus Christ, everything always be simple. If you claim and you want it to be, then we welcome you in churches around Ishawe. Any church you see here, you may go and knock. They will welcome you as a friend. Tell them you met Pastor Chris around the containers. They know who he is. They will approach you. They will tell you more about Jesus Christ. We will be very happy when you will reach those places. Jesus Christ
is not in my church only. Jesus Christ is not in my house only, but Jesus Christ is all over. Feel free, friends. Feel free to join churches around Ishao. Feel free to meet pastors around Ishao. Feel free to meet social workers around Ishao or psychologists around Ishao so they can teach you deep and deeper. Don't lose hope. Your life's still gonna be fine. You don't have demons. You are not possessed. But what I say, there is something cause trouble in your mind. What is that? Drug and beer. Stop it. You'll be fine. When you stop only, the same day you stop, 2-4 days, you will see change in your life. Example, you stop today, from tomorrow to next week, you will see how life is changed. You will see yourself. And another thing is the bad company, the bad. When you want a better change, try to separate with the bad friends. Those friends who don't give advice you. Don't those friends who want you to be in the wrong ways. Separate with them easy. Because they don't want your life to be better. Separate with them. They will talk shit about you, but there is another day they will follow you. They will follow you also. When you change, they will need also your advice. They will ask you, how did you change? You will tell them, I met someone who helped my life to be like this. And also them, they will follow you. In the name of Jesus Christ, let's be happy. When we meet, let's relax. When we meet, let's be brothers. When we meet, let's be in Christ strongly. Thanks for your time. I will come again next time to visit you. I will always come to be with you here until the last day I will see your change. Amen.
Bathi ukhona abantu abaphambukayo denege bona labo ya abasazi interest ne kulalela ivangeli likaNkulunkulu. Sizofunda isambulo 22 verse 15, sizokubeka phambili sizwe izadini kithi. Siyafunda isambulo 22 verse 15 nge ligama lika Kristo wase Nazareth liti, ngapandle kukona izinja nalabo abase benzelana nemimoya nezifebe nababulali nabakonza izitombe nawo wonke umuntu otanda futhi oqhubeka eqamba manga. 16, mina Jesu ngatuma ingelosi yami ukuba ifakaze gini ngalezi zinto zamabandla. Ngiyipande nenzalo kaDavidi nenkanyezi yokusa ekanyayo. Umoya nomlobokazi bathi oza. Noma ubani ozwayo magati oza. Noma ubani omile mageze. Na noma ubani otandayo magatate amanzi okupila ngesihle. Siyezwa bazalwane, iBhayibhele ithi abapambukayo naba izifebe abaphuzayo ababulali abatakati laba bonke abekho phakathi yalendlela sikhulumela ngayo.
Siyazi ini yabona le kwaya lo ya uyabulala vele. Mas you pemile, we are coolies, sfuba, that is crop. Then again, ban as we king. Why not get it? That is a problem, man.
We drink our police.
Fuga vele, masiti, mati, don't smoke because it abuses the head. Basho kanjal. Why get to pemela in because if I go na get pezul, but iyabulala, iyabulala, iyab. It means again, pila common le ya kubulala le lokwa. Iti, awazan kubone pepen, kubaluko na pezul kanjal. Eh, au funde la paya, ba ya paliwe. Funde na si
pepa na
na si na si pepa na. Funde la pozo wona ba ti na pezu.
Oji tina liyempela na ko.
Shabon. Eh, that's it. It means again. Why are we mlala ve? Hey, as if I'm less beggar now because you are police TV. Yeah, we are so very happy. The viewers, you will see how the men protect the cigarette as what cleaning is a bad feeling. It's a cigarette which makes him feel happy, and he prevent even to make a cigarette has something that makes him to get money. Now you will hear what the man himself was saying. The viewers, you will be happy, very happy, and you will laugh. This man need Christ in his life to as the Lord and the Savior and the Creator and everything, the solution of his life. We need you ministers around these places, come and visit him day by day until he will come to salvation. We will praise you, Jehovah Lord, Jehovah El Shaddai, when this man will see the light, when this man will see you the last day. Thanks very much for this time to be with this group here. We thank you very much, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. A lot of people, when it comes to problem, they always think that criminal activities is the solutions of their problems. But they always be totally wrong because they do fail. What I advise you today, my friends, come to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the best solution. When you have a million problems, make plan to meet the advocate of God, who's near you. Meet them for a better solution, because they will tell you the deep word. They will tell you the word of God. They will teach you the true way to heaven. And the word from the advocate of God will clean your mind, will help you to think as a normal person. Friends, remember in the book of Revelation, when Jesus Christ was calling people, everyone who's thirsty, to come to him. And he also, I'm calling you to come to Jehovah. I'm calling you to come to Jesus Christ.
However problem is, feel free. Join the good friends. Approach good friends. They will help you to change. They will always tell you about God. Because you are in a problem. The problem is in the ignorance of the gospel. Satan always takes advantage when you are in the ignorance of the gospel. But I remind you, come to the Lord Jesus Christ. We will show you the true way. We will teach you, and these teachings will light your brain. When your brain is lightening, you will see clearly the roads, and you will know which way to walk on. You will differentiate the way to heaven and the way to hell. If you have eye to see, let you see. If you have ear to hear, let you understand this truth. And this truth will set you free. Don't remain under the protection of a Satan. Come to God. Come to Jesus Christ freely. Give yourself. That is the true solution. Amen.